tell me that you want me, and I'll be yours completely, for better or for worse. I know we'll have our disagreements, be fighting for no reason. I wouldn't change it for the world. 'Cause I knew the first day that I met you, I was never gonna let you slip away. And I still remember feeling nervous, trying to find the words to get you here today. You make my heart feel like it's summer.
Here feel, don't we, everybody?
Yes.
To be with you both on this special and precious day in your lives. On behalf of Asha and Daniel, I would like to welcome you all as you come to celebrate the commitment of their new life together.
Today is the day you will always remember, the greatest in anyone's life. You'll start off the day just two people in love, and at the end, as husband and wife. It's a brand new beginning to start of a journey with moments to cherish and treasure. And although there will be times when you both disagree, these will surely be outweighed by pleasure.
This place has been sanctioned according to law for the celebration of civil marriages. Asher and Daniel, before you are joined in matrimony and publicly make this lifelong commitment, I have to remind you both that marriage according to the law of this country is the union of two people freely entered into for life to the exclusion of all others.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I? Daniel Jeffrey Woodall.
Daniel Jeffrey Woodall.
Shivani Kaur.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Daniel Jeffrey Woodall.
To Daniel Jeffrey Woodall.
Ashirani Kaur.
Ashirani Kaur.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
Ashirani Kaur.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Daniel Jeffrey Woodall.
Do take thee, Daniel Jeffrey Woodall.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
I, Daniel, to take you, Asha, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, to laugh together in joy, to grieve together in sorrow, to grow together in love as long as we both shall live.
I, Asher, take you, Daniel, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, to laugh together in joy, to grieve together in sorrow, to grow together in love as long as we both shall live.
I ask you to accept this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And my commitment to you.
And my commitment to you.
Great. And now, Asher, would you please take Daniel's ring and place it on the tip of his ring finger, as you say. I ask you to accept this ring.
I ask you to accept this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And my commitment to you.
And my commitment to you.
I now declare you to be husband and wife. Congratulations.
The ability to comprehend not only the spoken word, but those unspoken gestures, the little things that say so much by themselves. The key to love is forgiveness, to accept each other's faults and pardon mistakes, without forgetting but remembering.
Tell me that you
mine. to me loves all of you. And all your edges. All your perfect. And you give me all of you. Oh, how many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing.
Afternoon all. The first thing I'd like to say is thanks for everyone for coming today for our special day, especially those who have travelled from afar, such as America and Canada, to share our special day, and thank you all for the gifts too. Thanks to Ash's mum and my parents for helping us organise the day and raising us well. But my best part is thanks to my beautiful and kind wife for agreeing to marry me.
First of all, Asha, I am so proud of the beautiful, responsible, well, almost responsible, caring and sensitive person that you have become. You are the kind, compassionate and considerate of other people, and I admire the tenacity and the determination you have shown in the face of adversity. And it was an honour to walk you down the aisle.
And Asher and I first met on the first morning of our first day of A-levels, years ago. And even after knowing each other 5 minutes, we were laughing and talking as if we'd known each other our whole lives. And everybody else actually thought we did and had known each other our whole lives. And despite living in different cities, we've miraculously kept in touch and even managed to see each other every so often. And I know I'm not alone in this, because there's many of you today that have travelled hundreds, if not thousands, of miles to be here for Asher and Dan's wedding day.
Before I begin with the customary duty of giving Dan a very uncomfortable few minutes, I'd like to thank him, as when it comes to choosing the best man, I appreciate that it can be a difficult task. However, I suspect there are a few reasons why Dan chose me to be best man. First of all, he kind of realised that I'll probably be able to organise a decent stag do. Secondly, he probably thinks I'm not going to hammer him too much in the speech. We'll have to wait and see about that one. And finally, it's definitely because he wanted to look quite tall in the photos. This was Danny at the start of the stag do. In the airport, full of beans, happy and smiley, thumbs up. As you can see, things sort of went a bit downhill. I'll let you keep these, Dan. I mean, good luck in your new house.
Give me one more, guys! There we go. 3, 2, 1. Oh, nice.
Down all the way.
Look at each other, guys, smile.
what would I do without your spotlight? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm your magical mystery ride, and I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright.
Gentlemen, let's hear it from Mr. and Mrs. Woodall.
Love you.